Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're taking a look at the brand new Dropbox application. Now, Dropbox have released a new desktop edition that is currently in almost like a rollout stage. However, it is a brand new take on Dropbox. They're aiming to unify experiences for documents, for tasks, and also as almost like your hub for your team. So in today's feature, we're gonna take a look at Dropbox. We're going to start with a few of the key facts and information and then actually dive over to the laptop to dive into the desktop experience. So let's start with the fun stuff. Now, Drew Houston, who is the Dropbox CEO, announced this.
Talk to us about this updated user interface. It's a big overhaul.
We're really excited about it. It's been a big morning. We've launched the biggest change we've ever made to our product. It evolves the Dropbox experience from a folder full of files to a living team workspace where you can have not just files, but any kind of cloud content. So G Suite, things like Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides.
And obviously Dropbox is aiming to unify their application. They actually touch on like three core goals that they try and solve. Now, this isn't brand new news from Dropbox. I believe a week ago, we covered it on our news segment on the blog, that Dropbox actually launched a new pricing system with Dropbox Plus adding $2 more per month, making it $11.99. But it also, I believe, doubled the storage amount, which makes it a lot more effective for teams. Now, for those who don't know, Dropbox is being used by 13 million users worldwide, business users that is, and is distributed apparently across 400,000 teams, which is quite a large amount. Now, of course, for those who don't know, Dropbox is a pretty powerful cloud storage platform. And I think one of the things they're trying to solve with this addition is trying to unify applications like Slack, like Trello and Atlassian experiences, and also the things that you do day to day, like on Google Drive and other such platforms like Microsoft Word. They're trying to bring it into this one application. So guys, we're gonna jump over to the Mac and dive into what the desktop experience offers. Just before we dive in, big thanks to Bear for being a sponsor here on Keep Productive for June 2019. Let's jump over to Dropbox. So here we are with the new Dropbox. And as you can imagine, you can opt in to this new desktop experience for both Windows and Mac by using the opt-in link in the description. This will help you to basically get access to the new edition. I had to actually download it from scratch because I actually didn't have Dropbox installed previously. So to start, nothing in terms of the sync is changed. So for example, if you go to the Finder and you go up to the top, you can see that obviously you've got Dropbox and it's part of your favorites. And obviously you can still upload everything like you would normally and it would essentially be backed up on Dropbox. And of course the desktop edition actually allows you to upload photos and things like that. As you can imagine, it's really easy to do so. Now, I do not have a paid account. I have a free account, which I believe limits me quite a lot. But as you can imagine, I'm signed in on it. And obviously, I won't get the full, I believe it's 2 terabytes when you actually get the Pro plan or Plus plan. Then you've got the Pro plan. But I'll include the pricing in the description below. But let's just dive into this video. So Dropbox's aim is essentially with this application to tidy up your workflow. Now, what it wants to do is essentially bring in most of the sort of doing side of work, like the documents and be able to communication around documents together. So the first thing they want to do is to bring together messy files. And the way they want to do that is by creating a bit of an organized structure. And as you can see, I don't use Dropbox, so my sort of organization of my Dropbox account is pretty messy. But what you can do to get started is begin dragging this. So for example, you want to have a starred folder, you can drag it up here and it'll appear on the pinned sidebar. But you can also, you know, have it in this sort of folder system, which is quite nice. And if I wanted to see, for example, what's inside the Chrome productivity module, I can see all of the relevant details here. Now I could go about pinning the item. For example, I want to pin it to the top of the folder. That's quite helpful if I, you know, find a routine use for it. If I go out of this, you can see it pins to the almost sort of Dropbox panel that you have, which is quite helpful. And the other thing they want to try and do with sort of cleaning up the mess is notifications. So at the top of the page, you get what's called Dropbox notifications. From here, you can search Dropbox. You can actually go ahead and create a brand new area. We'll dive into that in a moment. And also you can access Dropbox Paper, which is currently still only available through web. I thought during this release they might make a new edition of it. And also through the notifications, you can start to see, you know, sharing abilities, so the most recent and what's up to date. And also, you can begin to start modifying some of the files you've already created, which is really handy. You can also see a sort of list of activities, so team activities. I don't have anyone in my team, but if you had people there, you can also see direct notifications, so which ones you've read. And for example, you know, you can tick them off and mark them as read and go through there. So that's quite an easy way to do it. So if you're looking for a sort of neat notification folder system, that's going to be really helpful. Now, you can go ahead, and the second thing they sort of mainly focus on is connecting with Slack, G Suite, and other applications. Now, as you can imagine, let's start with the other applications. Let's go from the back. This is the other applications access at the moment is shortcuts. If you don't have anything installed, for example, it just took basically the last Notion team page I went on, and it allows me to create a URL sort of shortcut. So I can say, this is the Notion team home. And if I go ahead and click create, what it will do is it will go ahead and create this sort of like easy access web file. It's actually a shortcut, but for example, if I wanted to pin it up here, maybe, I believe it should do it. Yeah, pin, there we go. So the pin actually allows you to open it really quickly and I can access that Notion folder really easily. So that's one of the great ways that you can access other applications. Obviously, if I want to connect and add other applications like Slack, then I can go here and connect the application. So I can do a range of different things. Okay, so obviously when you've got those connected, all you have to do is go into a certain file that you might want to share and double tap and actually press share in. Because if you press share, it would just bring up the regular Dropbox settings. So obviously being able to share the file, etc. But if I want to share in, I can share it directly to Slack. And this little sort of widget comes up here. Now I can share it directly with, for example, Alice. I could just directly send it to her or into a certain channel in this case. So if I wanted to as well, I could share it in Zoom. And this automatically will start a Zoom presentation. So as you can see, you can add your Zoom meeting ID in here and begin presenting through the web application. I'm not sure at the moment whether it has the ability to connect with the Zoom applications that's already available on Mac. So going back to the Dropbox area, you can also go ahead and create new areas like folders, shortcuts, and also Microsoft Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. And all this does is it simply launches the native application for each and gets you started. And the same with Doc, Sheets, and Slides. When you create a Google Doc, as you can see here, it will load up the Chrome edition of your browser. And whatever Google account you're logged in, it will obviously begin to create that file. Now you may be able to see that down here, you can see a Google document that's been created and you can access it at any given point, rename it and check the version history as well. And as you can see here, it will land inside of this. So being able to utilize the Google Drive and obviously be able to communicate all of these applications in one place is a pretty handy experience. Although I did think it would be a little bit more advanced than this. For example, having like a native way to be able to write up Google documents. But again, it's still fine to load up the web browser. So the final piece of the puzzle that Dropbox wants you to know, at least, is actually the sort of to-do, pinning, and organization. So with each of the pages that you create, for example, if I went into here, I can have this sort of like description space, but I can not only add notes, I can add lists, I can add bullet lists, numbered lists, and even to-dos, and even mention people here. Now, for example, there are a few suggestions that can get you going about how you want to organize that. But in this case, it could be like, tag Carl. Shall we continue to plan this one? And obviously Carl will get tagged. Now, if below I wanted to add a few bullet points, I could get going and I could even add a few to-dos if I wanted to be able to add a little bit more detail. I'm going to take this off because Carl will actually think I've messaged him in something. Now up here as well, of course, you can pin the most relevant features. So for example, if I wanted to pin all of this to the top, So pin it there, you can quick access there. And obviously you can modify all of the links and relevant information up here, because it can be quite a hub for your team if you begin to start organizing everything there. So one of the things you can do is you can go up to the top and start searching for relevant files and folders, and that obviously spans across your Word and also other access. So for example, if I typed in like Notion, then I can see all of the paper, the images, the files that I've stored in Dropbox paper, Dropbox in general, and even Google Drive that I've uploaded to Dropbox. So anything that you upload and create through Dropbox now will obviously be searchable, which helps. So for example, if I typed in like Google, as you can see here, oh, it didn't bring that one up, but I titled that one untitled. So it should appear. So there we go. It appears in the Google Docs area. So every new Google Doc you need to create through this application. So some of the additional things up here, you can obviously find out all the information about the file and be able to check in on version history. And you can even open it with a certain application if that's something that you want to do. I quite like that you can open up and go and navigate backwards. But in general, this application is pretty easy to do so. The new features are included in all Dropbox plans, both free and paid, and there is no inclusion charge. So that's one of the benefits to it. Again, I see this as a, obviously I don't use it in a team context, but I see this as a way for Dropbox to be able to unify a market. And with more additional integrations with Atlassian, which they're planning on, I think this is gonna be a nice addition. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the review of Dropbox. As you can imagine, Dropbox is a pretty powerful cloud platform. We do a lot more features like this, and we'll be doing more touching on tools, business tools that you can use in your daily routine. So if you're brand new here, hit subscribe, become a subscriber to keep productive. And if you haven't yet checked out all of our other courses, you can find our courses linked below if you wanna go deeper with an application. Anyway guys, a big thank you. I will see you guys in a future video. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.